Hello, this video is for summarizing working capital management chapter of our book Business Finance 1. It is the last chapter of our book and it is about defining working capital and its components, defining policies of working capital management, cash conversion cycle of a particular company, basic types of inventory and use in production process of a company, credit policies in the framework of receivables, and three main working capital financing decisions, which are aggressive, hedging, and conservative. We start with a definition of working capital. Working capital is current assets is current assets of our company, sorry. Here we have also net working capital. Net working capital is the difference between current assets and current liabilities of a company. I want to remind you that current assets are assets that are thought to be converted to a cash in less than a year. And current liabilities are liabilities that are to be paid in less than a year. So we want to also, I want to also remind you that a principle of a finance that is in general, current assets should be financed by current liabilities. Not every company or not every business line is, not every company is exactly following this rule, but it's just a rule of thumb that it is better for companies that most of their current assets are financed with short-term finances, short-term liabilities. So what are the current assets of a company? Current assets are cash in hand and in banks, account receivables, sundry debtors, inventories, prepaid expenses, and accrued income. Current liabilities are accounts payable, sundry creditors, outstanding expenses, bank payments, tax payments, and dividend payments. If we talk about the difference between current assets and current liabilities, it's a net working capital. We have permanent and variable working capital. Permanent working capital is a fixed amount that working capital is needed regardless of the amount of goods we produce. On the other hand, variable working capital is not fixed. It can be changed. It increases and decreases in times of increasing or decreasing the production volume or another effects or some other factors. So there should be almost always be available cash or cash instruments to be converted into a cash very quickly when needed. The permanent amount of working capital should be determined and should be no less than the regular requirements. If the firm has inadequate working capital, then it runs the risk of insolvency. We call the optimal level of working capital as it's the firm's maximizes the firm value, hence a trade-off between liquidity and profitability. This trade-off is important because if a company invests so much money in current assets, then it doesn't be able to have higher profitability because most of the profitability comes from non-current assets, longer-term assets that assets are invested for production of goods and services. So, if a company invests so much in the current assets, then its profitability is going down, but its liquidity is increased, and it can pay its short-term debts and daily expenses very easily, but profitability goes down. On the other hand, if a company invests so much in the non-current assets and invests so little in current assets, then it has the risk of liquidity that it cannot pay its short-term obligations. But these companies maybe profitability may increase. We are going to talk about three kinds of policies about working capital management. First one is hedging policy, second one is conservative policy, and third one is aggressive policy. If we talk about conservative policy, it is a policy that only fluctuating current assets is financed with short-term debt, and part of a fluctuating current assets, all of the permanent current assets, and all of the fixed assets are financed by equity and long-term debt. So this company would be called as conservative, because it doesn't have any risk of liquidity, and it doesn't have any risk of profitability. It invests so little in the it uses so little short-term debt, and it uses so many long-term debt. It is called conservative, and this is the hedging policies figure. If a company finances its fluctuating current assets with short-term debt, and finances its permanent current assets and fixed assets with equity and long-term debt, then it's a hedging policy. This policy is a mild policy that is not too conservative and not too aggressive. And profitability and liquidity is on the balance in this policy. And we have aggressive policy. With aggressive policy, company takes risks in order to get a higher profits, and finance is fluctuating current assets and some part of the permanent current assets with short-term debt, and it finances part of the permanent current asset and all of fixed asset with equity and long-term debt. So this is an aggressive policy, and it is a more it is riskier than a conservative policy. The being conservative or being aggressive is not just always associated with people. It sometimes associated with companies. We know that company managers runs the business, and they are people, of course. But sometimes not the personal traits leading the companies aggressive or hedging or like conservative. Sometimes it's the opportunities and fluctuations in the economy. I mean that for a company, for the same company and for the same manager, this person may sometimes make aggressive decisions in terms of financing their assets, and sometimes can be mild, and sometimes can be conservative. So please keep in mind that these are not the policies that cannot be changed. They change all the time, all for all the person or for time to time. And we finish with the policies, and we see here elements of working capital management. When we talk about management, we are talking about how a manager can manage its current assets and current liabilities, mostly the current assets. So each item in the balance sheet can be managed individually with care. For example, cash management, inventory management, and receivables management. And in this slide, we have again policies as a summary. We have seasonal current assets, permanent current assets, and fixed assets. And we have conservative, aggressive, and moderate. Each, for each of the item of the working capital, a manager can be conservative, aggressive, and moderate. And the managers can find a balance between cash, inventory, and receivable. I hope this video summarizes chapter 8 well.